Alright, so I died in between episodes, trying to get back to where I died, because when I was fighting these spiders that I ran past, oh fuck, I'm slipping, it decided to lock onto an enemy across from the pit after I killed the spiders, which made me attack off the edge and into the center of that vortex. However, I did get this item, so, you know, it's got something when I lost those 16,000 souls. Down here. Watch out for the exploding lizard. There's that basilisk. Kill this. Oh, geez, he's got double bows. It looks like each one fires three arrows. Okay, this is gonna be an annoying fight. There's shit everywhere. I need to get some cover. Right, takes a long time to heal. Alright, I was trying to get back down behind that first guy where I dropped down the first time we went to that pit, but I ended up over here instead because I forgot how to get there. I don't think I've explored down here. Oh, somebody's been petrified. Clearly not one of the people I can revive. With a, willow branch of yore. Wilted branch of yore. Weakness message. A torch. A titanite. Spider human. A basilisk. Why do basilisks in this game have such a tiny head compared to the normal design? Or are these a different kind? Too heavy to open, what? Something horrible is gonna spill out when I break this, aren't they? It was a lot of sand. It really does get everywhere. It's locked. There's been a surprising lack of locked doors in this area. Just a lot of doors you can open. Already went in there. Sounds like the sand vortex is just on the other side of this rock. Titanite chunk. Always use more of those. Those are the second best regular upgrade item. Okay. Just before Titanite slab. Alright, well, it looks like that's all I can do over here. Well, I guess I probably can't get back over to the other side from here. Welcome to the Crystal Mines. What do you want to bet that these things petrify you if you touch the spikes? Or they just give you damage? Try dash. Is something bad gonna happen? Guess not. Tears ahead. Alright, let's try touching these and see what happens. Okay, they do damage you over time. There are some items down there. Anything hidden back in that corner? No. Probably don't need to mess with these guys. I don't know if they'll attack me, though. Oh, that's a good one. Man, that's a good noise. Peasant long gloves. So do they need a specific dark tool to be able to mine this bright stone? Alright, so there might be another boss ahead? Or just more spiders. That's a lot of spiders. I wonder if there's going to be a spider boss in this area. Again, they're not tough individually, I just don't want to get hit by all of them at once. I will say that going from Dark Souls 3 back to 2, you really seem to react to hits a lot less. I don't know if that's just because I have good poise, so I'm not getting staggered by them, but getting hit, it doesn't even really seem like you get hit. There's not a good indication of that. It's like, oh, my health's going down. I guess I got hit. So we'll have a hero, gold pine resin, so that's some lightning damage I can add. Poison arrows. Man, there are a lot of arrows in this area. Three more spiders. Locked door, a summon, Manhunter O'Hara. She's got a big ass bow. Oh. Which would be real handy for all these spiders. Put on some pants, lady. She's got this big ass bow and then just short shorts and like heels. Spider is mocking me. That's his lever here. Oh, good. Another phantom. So he got staggered there, I could have front-stabbed him. Peasant hat, plus 5. Is she using herself to string that bow? See how she fires this thing. Or are you just gonna stand there? Okay, she has a smaller crossbow. I like to keep this handy for close encounters. Not even sure what I took damage from when he was dying. Bonfire? Somewhere around? The spider cave? Dark spirit ahead. Another one? Oh yeah, there's definitely gonna be a big ass spider at the bottom of all this. Or perhaps a half spider, half human. think there are any more Witches of Izalith by this point. Believe me, I am always wary of behind. That's what those short shorts are for. You know, you've got a big-ass bow. You could shoot them before they pounce on us. Torch. If only I could set this web on fire. Spider web is pretty flammable from what I know. And I wasn't even one of those sociopath kids that set webs on fire. Because I guess that was a thing. The kids did. Pharos Lockstone. Also, why is it every book that has a bunch of kids put into a bad situation, one of them is a sociopath? Like Battle Royale, the book I recently read about a bunch of scout kids put on an island and infested with a experimental tapeworm. I mean, I guess that's one of the best ways to explain a blatantly evil child. It's just, no, he's a sociopath. Which, I mean, not all sociopaths are, you know, serial killers. Just because you're unable to comprehend emotion doesn't necessarily make you a non-productive member of society. It just makes you very hard to get to know. These guys don't even have spiders, they're just fucking peasants trying to kill me. Maybe the people of Brightstone Cove began to worship the giant spider living underneath them. Alright, I'm running low on Estus flasks, but I got plenty of life gems left. I heard a summon sign pop up somewhere. Ashen Knight Boyd. Can have quite the little retinue going on here. I guess I should be shielding up against these guys more. Can I get that? Bandit axe. Simpleton spice. More spiders. I get a feeling the next room is the boss. In fact, there's a fog door right there, so it obviously is. Is there anything else around here? Like, perhaps a bonfire. Probably missed the bonfire. There's an item up there. And I think that's the only thing I missed in this specific part of the area. Should be able to just kind of make my way up there. Twilight Herb. It's not like I'm missing a lot of stuff, though. A lot of this stuff seems like stuff I don't really need. Which I guess is kind of what you expect from Dark Souls. It's always stuff that's useful if you're playing a certain way, but not necessarily useful to everybody. Like all those arrows I keep finding. Actually, I don't think I can get back up. I guess I go up here. Zweihander. Or Zweihander. Something like that. It's German. I don't actually know how to pronounce it properly. But I mean, it literally just means two-hander. You know, zwei, two. Also one of the few, like, comically oversized, almost anime-sized swords that was used in real life. I'm trying to remember if that's the sort of sword that was used for cutting a horse in half or not. It's like, the claymore is Scottish, and I don't think the Scots fought a lot of mounted infantry. Spider got my friend right there for a second. Alright, let's see what's waiting for us on the other side of this mist. I'm sure our arrow lady will come in handy here. I don't know what's up with this effect, but it kind of looks like shit in the boss cutscenes. That, like, heartbeat effect. That is a large spider. Ugh, another minion boss. Let me pour you a cup of spiders. Alright, I bet she crushes her own spiders though. We got two targets, a spinneret, and a head. Oh, she has two heads. Yep, she has two heads. The Duke's deer. Now, is she the Duke's deer because she's a giant spider? Or was she once not a spider? And that is a magical beam. Shit, I hit the leg. Well, O'Hara seems to be doing alright over there. Except for what she got blasted in the face. Oh boy. That went right over my shield. So basically just want to go for the head that she's not currently using. Bounces right off of her armor if you don't hit the head. And that looked like a grab. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if she tried to eat me. Man, you really have to hit her from head on. Fly directly to the spider's forehead. The answer is no, you cannot roll through that. Oh, come on. Just spawned it right where I was standing. I'm gonna go for the other head. And I didn't hit her again. Joke of those. I just keep missing. I don't want to get close because that attack is hard to get away from. At least I can block it. Takes all my stamina, though. I don't want to burn all my life gems. Right before she does an attack, it seems like the ground gets sticky. It gets a whole lot harder to back away if you don't roll. Probably slows me down if I get hit by it. I'd rather not get hit by it. That should have finished too there. Oh my god, just die, spider. I'm just doing nothing to her. I'm dead. Bosses with very specific weak points are kind of annoying. Alright, gotta walk all the way back there. I guess I could try to deal with that pit first, before we go back to the boss. Alright, so the key to this pit is to take out the caster first, because otherwise he's just gonna keep harassing me. And also not to explode. It seems like that lizard is not respawning. Did I actually go in this room? I feel like I opened the door and then walked away. It's okay, still healed for more damage than he did. His double bows. Backstab this guy. I guess those are his only weapons. He doesn't actually have real weapons. Begone from my world. You gonna give me your silly little bow things? Nope, just a human effigy. Alright. I was gonna say, what's in here? It's another spider. Are you a mimic? Crescent Axe and Soul Vortex. I already have a crescent axe. I guess not. Bronze great axe. I could use that. I have high enough strength. How do I get in there? I guess there's just a door. Okay, so it's all with those guys. I've got to deal with that caster still and this whatchamacallit. Basilisk. This one hiding under the ground here. Just see his one eye sticking out. I don't know, I guess that's his whole face. I don't know, I kind of prefer the silly bulging eye version that's in the other two games. Ah, the creepy baby statue room. Is that a chest? It does not appear to be a chest, but it also doesn't appear to be something I can just break. Another lockstone. Flame butterfly. Is that a weapon or a spell? Oh no, that's an item. Found those before. Let's just let you light a torch. Durr. Thought I found something new and exciting. It's like a sacrificial altar or something. Whatever it is, I can't do anything with it. Spiders out here. I am a caster guy. Take cover and heal. Have pretty good homing. It's a good thing enemies never ever run out of magic power. They can just spam this thing forever. Okay, so I can't go up this thing where the spiders came from, but that leads back to where I was before. Looks like maybe there's a wall here. A hidden wall, rather. There's obviously a wall here. What about up here? Can I jump this? Sort of. I don't think I'm supposed to be able to. Is there anywhere to go? Okay, so there's a bonfire there. A bunch of spiders. Door I can't open. I'm guessing I can't break this door. And it's not hidden in any of these walls. Maybe I need a torch in this room. Maybe that's why there was a flame butterfly in here. Bonfire, try attacking. No, it's just the shelves. How do I get to the bonfire? Can I do anything with this box? It just seems strange that I can't interact with it in any way. Here. Okay, so this connects to the other area. I think this was locked from this side. Oh, I can't go back, though. Alright. And I already went in there. I'm trying to remember how to get back to where we were. Back out here. It's locked. I think that's the door that I tried to attack. Oh no, it can't be because the bonfire was in that room. I'm a little turned around. I'm trying to figure out how to get to that bonfire. Even though it's not really that much of a shorter path from the other one. I think there's another one we missed on the way. There's a spider here. Alright, so this leads back into the caves. Oh shit. Nope. He's just gonna keep spamming me, so I can't just climb past him. I just wanted to not have to fight the whole room full of spiders. Alright, well, we're back here at the fog gate. I might try using my ultra greatsword here, or just greatsword as it's called, ironically, even though it's an ultra greatsword. But the problem with that is that equipping this makes my roll slower. I go from medium roll to fat roll. I don't have the archer here this time. Watch out for that laser. I completely missed that swing. Swing and a miss. Alright, so this time I've got my boy Ashen Knight Boyd with me. Hopefully he can tank for me while I try to smack this other head. God damn it. Oh man, she just has a lot of face protection. I think I could break those off with enough hits, but I probably can't. Yeah, I'm not sure why you kind of slow down when she does that. Yeah, block that though. No matter which way you're facing. I mean, a lot of the bosses in this feel like they're designed to be fought by more than one person. Because, I mean, like, she can attack both of us at the same time here. Down for a sec, though. At least staying in front of her will keep the beam from just hitting me instantly. She always pans left or right. Well, that was easy enough. Now, obviously, there's some stuff we missed in Brightstone Cove. Oh. Was that one of the four giant souls I'm supposed to be retrieving? Is that the soul of this dragon who has been dead for so long? I'm trying to remember if they name the great souls early on, you know, with the typical cutscene that's like, here's all the dead people you gotta fight, or the people that you will have to fight. I don't think it does, though, but, yeah. Pretty sure this dragon was our target. Alright, is there a primal bonfire here to light? Like there was with the other one. Key will open up stuff in Brightstone. Interesting. I wonder if I could have gone backwards then? But now the real fight begins. Alright, so I guess that's it for Brightstone Cove Tseldora. I mean, obviously there's some cleaning up to do, but that's stuff I can do on my own in between videos. It sounds like there's still something here of importance. Also, there's no bonfire to warp back to Majula. There's a curse. Try the ladder. Nope, this string does not appear to be a ladder. Let me try to miss anything here. Alright, so... oh, that's not the way I want to go. Let's head back into that next area, and hopefully there'll be a bonfire so I can warp back to Majula and give the Emerald Herald this soul. Or I guess, show it to her. There's a bonfire. And this actually seems to be an empty room. So I guess... everyone's trying to amp you up. Now there's the primal bonfire. Also, I noticed the bonfire sword is broken on this one. When you think about it, it's kind of weird that there's a sword in the bonfire. And that the bonfire is entirely composed of the firekeeper's bones. There's really nothing that flammable in there. Alright, you got anything to say about my victory?
The soul and the curse are one and the same. I only hope it brings you what you wish.
I like her voice actor, though she does kind of sound a little Irish sometimes. I'm not sure if that's intentional or just kind of the accent slipping in.
That tiny thing inside the ruins. An ancient being that will mock your very existence. She imparts sound wisdom. Provided you find her on a good day. The sign you bear.
Is she talking about a cat?
And without stay strong, even when you have.
Alright, I guess she has nothing to say about that second primal bonfire I've ignited. Alright, so that seems to be the end of that direction. So I guess the Earthen Peak is the... or not Earthen Peak. Earthen Peak? Yeah, Earthen Peak is the next place to go, and kind of the only place I can go right now, I think. Black Gulch. No, alright. Black Gulch is another area that I opened up. That looks like another poison hell. So yeah, I guess any of the places with the orange are leading up to one of the great souls. But maybe not, because some of these places were orange and they aren't now. So maybe that just means I am missing something. Anyhow, that's it for this little adventure in Dark Souls 2. I will come back with this again some other time, as well as Dark Souls 3. I'll just be kind of switching off between them. Anyhow, I'm Shadefire, and this is Dark Souls 2, and you folks all take care. Take easy, folks.